Welcome back, and it's time for our Ask Us Anything segment, where listeners to the show come onto our Facebook page and they ask us, well, anything, quite frankly. And this week, I've got a philosophical motherfucker for you this week. Okay, listener, Kate Cav asks, do you believe in God? Quite simply.
Is there an option B? Like, is it, do you believe in God or would you rather eat seven sausages?
It's not.
That's what I'm used to. Damn it.
It's not an either or. You know, it's not, yeah, it's not that. It's simply, do you believe in God?
Well, way to keep it light, Kate. Well, I identify as agnostic, so technically that would be a no, but I'm not completely adverse to the concept.
Oh, dear. No, yeah. I don't know.
That was quite interesting, because I've got no idea what you three think.
No.
I could have had a punt. What I reckon you guys are, but yeah, I have no actual idea of what your beliefs are. Funnily enough, it's nothing we've ever really covered on Twitter chats when we're generally doing knob gags and paedophile and AIDS jokes, is it?
Not really, no. But I guess it's an interesting one. I mean, I'm not sure is my honest answer. I think I would just give the stock answer that no, but I feel there's something out there. Whether that's, I don't know.
Well, that's sort of an agnostic as well.
Yeah, a gaseous cloud. I'm not sure, but yeah, I find it hard to believe that there is some dude with a beard up on a cloud kind of dictating all of our fates just by a click of his fingers. If it's Morgan Freeman, like in Bruce Almighty, something like that, then yeah, happy days, but no. Mids, are you a believer?
I think we already know. I think we already know that it's a no from me. And not even like there could be anything. There's nothing, man. That's the way I look at it anyway. There's nothing. I like gods like Zeus and all that kind of stuff. But
got a war.
The actual god that I think the question's referring to, then no, I don't think exists.
Sin, I know what your answer's going to be, but please enlighten us.
I'm strong in the mid camp. I am 100% no. I can't sign up for it as a concept. And I don't know. I'm fascinated by it though. I would say it's one of the things that fascinates me the most. And I have a little bit of jealousy for anyone who can believe in a god, because I think it shows an ability to do something that I can't. I need some sort of evidence or something to kind of hang my hat on to kind of believe in anything like that, and it's just devoid of that. And yeah, I do think it's quite amazing that people can make the leap of faith, but no, I just can't buy into it. And again, much like Mid, I love mythology, and I love the idea of the gods of old and things like that, but any modern gods, if you can refer to them as modern gods, none of the religions, I just don't buy it. And especially that, the fact that there's so many religions, I don't know how you could have so many competing gods and people still think that their god's the right god. So yeah, leaves me massively cold, man.
What we need is a god-based Royal Rumble, really, don't we?
Yeah, I'll be down for that.
30 gods in a ring, one winner comes out. It would have to be like 1992 Rumble, wouldn't it? So you actually make crown a champion at the end of it.
Oh, Vincent, yes. To come out though and win it, wouldn't he? He'd beat his old partner, God.
He'd, he would, actually. Oh, God, I've forgotten that angle.
He'd book himself over God, easy.
I'd forgotten that. Oh, my days. Yeah, Christ. When God was an actual character in WWE for a period. Jesus.
If I was a better man, which I clearly am, I would have gone no for Mid. And no-ish for DRB, but with a curiosity. And Stu, I was really unsure on you. I didn't know, and nothing we'd ever talked about. I don't know.
Cause I love the concept of faith. You know, I kind of make it. I think there's a bit of a distinction between having having faith in something to kind of guide your life, and then believing in someone that can do miracles. They don't feel one and the same to me. That's kind of how I feel about it in my head. But I think it's like a coping mechanism for a lot of people, isn't it?
Yeah,
I think that. You know, what is the alternative? The alternative is you just die and that is it. You obviously your corpse becomes rotting and decayed. You become worm food.
And that is one of the things that fascinates me, is kind of that concept of going, like, why? Well, it sounds terrible. Sounds like I'm going to do something bad. Like, why do I bother going on if I think that this is really fine, mate?
Jesus.
Why? But why am I doing the stuff that I do? And why don't I go out there and just do whatever I want, whenever I want, to whoever I want? But you're right. You kind of, whether it be a religion that holds you in check, but you build some sort of moral code for yourself, don't you? I mean, like, I did go to like Sunday school and church and stuff when I was a kid because my mum and dad believed. But as soon as I was given like any choice, I was like, no, I'll stay at home and watch cartoons. And I guess that's where I built my moral compass from, was the heroes from the comic books and the cartoons. And
Tom and Jerry.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't know. I do think it's a fascinating subject. And it's a shame because I don't believe. I think whenever I talk to someone who does believe, I've got so many questions to them that it sounds like I'm just having a go. And I'm not. I'm just massively curious. And because I think there's a lack of logic in some of it, when you ask questions based on logic, people do sometimes take a bit of offence, as if you're just sort of saying, well, you're dumb for believing in that. But I'm like, no, I need to kind of get into your head and understand. Well, I mean, like, it's an age of one, but like, understand how you can think that there weren't dinosaurs despite all of the compelling evidence that there were dinosaurs. And if you now acknowledge that there are, how can you believe in an infallible religion that's based off stuff that said there wasn't for so long and things like that? I just find it great. We need to get someone on here to educate me on religion on this podcast.
That'd be hilarious. Fucking hell.
And by the sound of it, it's not a you three.
Not really, no. I mean, I do lean more towards atheist than Christian, obviously, but only because there's no proof that there's nothing. I have to identify agnostic. I don't know there's nothing.
Mm-hmm. Do you know, I don't know if you guys
have that makes sense.
I had an absolute panic attack when I was like in my mid-teens. I just woke up in the middle of the night and I'd been like just thinking and pondering all night about what happens when you die. And it's like it just at that point clicked with me that nothing happens, and that just I went into proper full panic attack. So I can see if people are experiencing that, then clinging on to this, you know, this idea of religion and the afterlife is something that is quite appealing to people. But
yeah, if it gets you through, then fair play to you. Yeah,
but yeah, I mean personally I've made my acceptance with death. That sounds rather morbid, but
I'm just sitting here watching the clock, waiting for the minutes to pass.
This is not our usual light opening, I have to say. It's
got less Nazis than usual, but that's about it.
Yeah, it is an interesting question, and one. That...
By the way, I think you can still be spiritual without being religious. Mm. You know, you can still make spiritual connections with other people. In certain settings, like if you were to go to a comedy show, obviously we can't, we're in lockdown, but when you do, you laugh in a different way to how you would just one-on-one, you know, that sort of communal thing. So I think someone religious can probably get spirituality in a different way than we could, but it doesn't mean we can't find it at all.
You know, I'm welcome to be proven wrong. God, if you are out there, feel free to send me a message. I'd love to be one of these people that have
he could become a Patreon, couldn't he? That'd prove it.
Yeah, I could see myself in the Catholic Church, you know.
God has subscribed. That'd be amazing. A few years ago, I did a bet on one of the Super Bowl bets, and it was who the MVP would thank first. And being a predominantly American sport, I pumped for God. And Tom Brady, the dick splash that he was, didn't. He thanked his family first. But it was an amazing thing when I looked back at my Betfair account and it just said, God lost. That's
amazing. Oh, dear. Yeah. That would have been a sure bet, surely.
No, I thought so. But I may, luckily, I was still a winner that night because I put an amount of money that I don't ever want to admit out loud on... Missy Elliott coming out and doing a surprise performance at the halftime show, And it wasn't looking good. The clock was ticking, and then all of a sudden, Get Your Freak On hit in the background. And I actually did a lap around my garden because I was very, very worried about how much money I was going to lose on such a stupid bet.
You got your freak on in your garden.
I did.
Wow, there you go. Yeah, thank you, Kate, for that. If you want to get involved, then please head over to our Facebook group and submit your questions. We are running a bit low now, so get them in so we can have some for the next show.